Hi guys, good evening and welcome to those that are online and also welcome to those that are listening to the recording at a later stage. Let me just switch my video on for you quickly. There we go. Okay. All right. I'll jump in and get started because I know otherwise it gets late. Everybody to be online and with supper and load shedding and everything else, it can get a bit much. So again, you guys are aware these sessions are recorded and they will be uploaded for you guys to listen to again afterwards, or for those that weren't in the live session to listen to at any point afterwards. This first session that we're going to have this evening is very much an introductory session. It's just some important background and information that I want to cover, things that your materials and how to use them, what you should have, what you should be doing, how things work is really what we're going to cover in this evening's collab. Okay, so you guys know you are distance students, so you are self-directed learners. You manage your learning yourselves together with the information and materials and support that we give you, but you don't actually have classes or lessons as such in the way that full-time students attend lectures and have a whole session of lectures where all the content is taught to them. So what we are here for as tutors is to be available to you, for you to ask us questions. That's so important. If you don't ask questions when you've got them, then you're going to battle. That's our whole raison d'etre is to be here to answer questions for students. So don't ever feel shy or that you've been a nuisance or anything with any question at all. It is our purpose. And then when I get questions from students, it also gives me an idea of what if people are battling with, what are common areas that students need help with. And then in the collabs that we have hereafter, I'll be able to address those questions, which then hopefully are common to everybody. Okay. So I've got a list of things that I'm going to talk about, which will basically hopefully answer most of the questions that you have got already as to how to get going and where to find stuff. So the first thing that I want to say is that there are three critical items that you guys will use to work through this module. And if you don't use these three items, you are not likely to do well. So bear with me and just make sure that this is what you do. So the first thing is this module outline that you can see on the screen right here. It's the first very important document. You must download it. You will find it in your student materials folder for the module. And print it if you are able to. It's not that many pages, so that you've got it to make notes on and to keep with you while you are sitting at your computer working through your learning units. And I'm going to go through some of the pages in it to show you exactly how to use it and why it is so important. So the first number one is your module outline. Number two is your textbook. Absolutely have to have the textbook, and your textbook is going to be your 99.9% of what you will use to study all the way through the semester and prepare yourself for the assignments and for the exam. Everything you need is in the textbook, and that's where you go. Not videos and not slides and not all the rest of them, which are nice to watch and nice to look at and listen to, but in order to pass the module, module outline, textbook, and then the third thing is your the learn content, which again I'm going to show you. Those three things you as distance students will use together to work your way through the module. Because it's self-paced, everybody is working, you guys have all got different programs and commitments, etc., so you're working on your own. So using those three things, you'll be able to make sure that you can self-guide yourself and get through everything timeously and allowing yourself to cover everything. Okay, I can't emphasize how critical that is. All right, so let's just have a look at, so this is the module outline. Hopefully you have guys have downloaded all of them. So work your way through all of this, read every page. I'm not going to go through every page here with you now, but that's not to say that they're not all important. It's just obviously to save time. So using this module outline, if you are watching on screen, top left of your screen on a laptop, you'll find the little magnifying icons to zoom in and zoom out. So use those to make what you can see on the screen larger or smaller when I cast a document up onto the screen. So this module outline specifically has been developed to support your learning. Okay, that's what it's for, and you must use it. It's not something that you don't refer to. It's critical that you work with it. So your content of this module is on Learn, as well as in the prescribed materials. Your prescribed material is your textbook. And you will not succeed in this module if you focus on this document alone. While they say this document alone, they say in the module outline, but I don't think anybody would be under that impression. You need Learn itself, your online system, your textbook, and this module outline. Okay. And the reason why they say not this document alone, underneath this, they say this document doesn't contain all of the content that is on Learn. So this is just kind of like a guide. This is why we call the module outline. We also call it the PACER. So it's your guide, and from this guide, you will then go to Learn, which does contain all the content and links to different resources, etc., and then obviously your textbook. So this module on Learn, you guys know that you're online students, distance students. So Learn itself, so the Learn system, which contains content from your module, is going to support and maximize your learning in an active manner, and its main purpose is to guide and pace you through the module. So you will sit there in front of at your desk with your computer with Learn open in it, with your module outline and your textbook on your desk with you, and with those three things you will then work your way through the module. So other things that are on Learn is your prescribed material, all sorts of additional online resources like links to articles, links to YouTube videos, audio clips, interactive graphics, all kinds of other interesting things that Learn uses to engage you and guide you through each learning unit. Okay. So we are distance students, so therefore, it says here, unless you are completing this as a distance module, well, we are completing this as a distance module, so therefore Learn replaces what would be contact time with the lecturer if you were a full-time student. So you won't be going into a classroom face-to-face every day with a lecturer. So we have given you Learn to stand in for that role, and then together with those resources you've got your tutor to ask questions and to unpack any problems with the content that you've got. So with all of that together, you guys have got everything that you need to do well in the module. Okay, so you are required to engage extensively with the content on the Learn platform. Effective use of this tool, so really use it, and in this case it will honestly help you. These numeric modules really Learn really comes to the fore in assisting students with these numeric modules. So this next page is just kind of like a little explanation of the icons that you will find when you log on to Learn and you're working through all the pages on Learn. Different pages will have these icons on them, and this explains what that page will then be showing you. Is it your learning objectives? Is it just something to think about? Is it an active learning section, etc.? So you've got that page just to, as kind of like a little, okay, your module resources, prescribed material. So here is the details for your textbook. So hopefully you guys have already, they would have given you the Wise Books link, etc. when you registered for your modules. Hopefully you have done that and you have got your textbook already. Sometimes you guys are able to get a secondhand textbook from past students, which is absolutely fine. If you have got a textbook that's a year or two old, it won't be out of date and you will be able to use it, just as long as it's not too old. And if I'm not sure at this stage what new material is in it, if they have given us a 2023 textbook and what new material is in it. But the onus is on you if you've got an older textbook to make sure that go and sit in the library on campus one day and just look through the new textbook and against your old book and just check to see if there's anything missing. Okay, the module purpose, those are the module outcomes, what we want you to know by the time you finish the whole module. Those two pages are for the full-time students. So here is a very important page in the module outline, and that is the page giving you the details for your assessments. So take note, 5122 is our code. Make sure whenever you are accessing this code that it has got the W behind it, because that W designates that it is the online version of the information related to the 5122 accounting 2B. Okay. It's really important where it comes to these assessments, because you can see here you guys do two assignments, whereas the full-time students, you would have seen on those previous two pages that I went past, they do two tests. All of you do an examination, which is the identical paper that is written on the exact same date at the exact same venues. So take note, your exam is a closed book exam and it will be written in person on a campus. So if for any reason, being a distance student, you have an issue with that, then engage immediately with the admin people to arrange exactly how that's going to work for you. So we've got four different assessments that will make up together, the marks will make up your final module mark. So you know that your pass mark must be 50% or more. So hopefully you are going to aim for 60, 70, 80% and to make sure that you definitely fly past that 50% mark. And the way this is made up is your first assignment is 25% of your total mark. Your second assignment is 30% of the total mark, and the exam counts 35%. 35% of your exam mark will go towards the total mark. And then the remaining 10% is made up of your ICE tasks. So let's just go to the assignment one first of all. So your assignment one is going to be on the first two learning units. I just need to turn a light on here because it's starting to get dark and I am currently in load shedding, which is a bit of a puzzle because our load shedding actually finished at 4 o'clock and we weren't supposed to have another lot. So I don't know what's going on. Oh, there goes my lamp. Trying to balance it where. Sorry, guys, give me a secchi. Okay, hopefully that's better. I'm sure we're all going to encounter these load shedding issues as we go along, which is also why it's a nice thing that everything will be recorded and saved for you guys. Okay, so assignment one, the first two learning units, which is your bank recon and debtors and creditors recon. Now, where the debtors and creditors recon, learning unit two, that chapter is a new, there is a new section in the 2023 textbook that is not in any of the older textbooks. So if you have got an older textbook, Learner Unit 2, go and have a look in the campus library through that chapter and find those missing pages and just see if they'll allow you to photocopy just those few pages or otherwise for this year, try and get a 2023 version of the textbook, okay? That is one change that I do know about in all of the textbooks for the different modules. So your assignment one is due on the 18th of April. So you're lucky you guys have still got quite a bit of time leading up to that. And we will have a special collab session just dealing with that assignment before the due date. Where are we here? 5122. And that will be on the 5th of April. So the national support session is what we call them. Will be on the 5th of April, and all your assignment questions will be answered then. Obviously, if you are working on the assignment before that, you are welcome to ask me questions as you go along. Don't ever save up questions for collab dates. Always ask me as soon as you've got them. Okay. Okay, so then ICE, how does that work? So this 10% here, you need to do 4 tasks. All of these ICE tasks will be learn activities, which means you within learn, you'll see in each learning unit, they'll have 1 or 2, sometimes 3 activities, which gives you an opportunity to practice the work in that learning unit. I use those learn activities as ICE tasks. So I will give you a list. So ICE will be learn activities. I will give you a list of 6 tasks, and you must do 4 of them. And it is your choice which 4 of those 6 tasks you complete, but you must do 4, not less than 4, otherwise you won't get that 10%. If you only do 1 of the tasks, you'll only get 2.5% of that 10%. Then the way that I work with us is that I work with 1 final us due date, which in this case is going to be the 2nd of June. And I think that is a Friday. So by midnight on Friday, the 2nd of June, you must have completed all 4 us tasks in order to get that 10%, that 10% towards your 50%. Okay. So when I will either what tomorrow's Thursday, Friday, hopefully still this week, I'll send out the list of ICE tasks. If not, it will definitely be next week. So you can start working on those ICE tasks. As soon as you get the list, you are welcome to start completing the tasks. All of them you will find on Learn. I'll explain to you how to find them. You don't have to wait. And there is 1 final due date by which time all of your ICE tasks must be completed. If you complete anything after the 2nd of June, it will not be marked because we have to close off, collate the marks and send them up to head office so that they can start calculating your CAS mark for exam entrance for the semester. So you've got plenty of time to do the ICE. Make sure you, and I will send you reminders now and again throughout the semester. So it, again, the onus is on you to make sure you keep up to date, you constantly remind yourself and you go back and you work on ICE and you complete 4 ICE tasks. With the 2 assignments, you have got those due dates in the pairs already. I'll show you that in a minute. And before each assignment, we will have a special collab just to go over any questions that you've got for that assignment specifically. So you'll have the support for that. And the same thing for the exam. Once we've got the exam dates, there will be one collab held specifically for exam support to go through any questions that you've got just for the exam itself. Okay, and then from this page in the module outline, the PACER begins. So remember, we call this the module outline or the PACER. And that is because from this page, learning unit by learning unit, they start giving us information. So for learning unit one, sorry, just one sec. I've been talking for a while already. Just needed some water. Okay. Learning unit one, bank reconciliation. So throughout this PACER, you've got two pages for each learning unit. The first one looks like this, which gives you an overview, describes what the learning unit is going to be all about. And then where is that other section? They seem to have taken that out for some of the modules. I don't know why. Okay, they used to have on this page over here, they used to also have an indication to say you should be completing. Just have a look. What was it last year? You should be completing learning unit one in weeks one and two. Learning unit one. Okay, and then that's a suggested pace. So we are currently, we are currently in week two. Once the semester starts, it goes so quickly. And that is academic week two. So the total PACER learning units generally are divided over 12 academic weeks. And then in the semester in total, we've got 16 weeks. So towards the end, you've got those extra 4 weeks before the exams to then do revision and catch up before the weeks. So kind of allow yourself 12 weeks to cover all of the content and then 4 weeks immediately before the exams to revise everything for the exams. And then if you can stick to that, then you will definitely be okay in terms of being able to allow yourself enough time to prepare properly for the exam. Okay, so the first page is then this overview. And the second page for each learning unit gives us the theme breakdowns. So this is still learning unit one. It's the theme breakdowns. And here you can see we've got two themes in learning unit one, which is the business and the bank, which is a little bit of theory. And then the second theme is the bank reconciliation, which is the actual practical exercise of completing the bank reconciliation. So you can see again, similarly to 5121, accounting 1A, this is a very practical module, which means you have to absolutely, in order to pass the module, constantly throughout the semester, practice. Your examples in each learning unit and your questions in each learning unit, complete them in your workbooks. Okay. Because it's accounting is a skill that you have to actually learn to master. And the only way that we master any skill is by practicing that action over and over again until we get proficient at it within a faster and faster time period. Because remember, your exam is a restricted time. So you need practice also makes us speedier at completing tasks, as well as making sure that we know how to complete the task without looking at a solution. And then if you carried on, the next page in the outline will then take you to learning unit 2. And then again, the same story. So here is the overview for learning unit 2, debtors and creditors reconciliation. And some background. And then on the second page, again, you have got the details with the theme. Oh, one thing I think very important theme to learning, you know, two themes. Here we've got two themes. Now, these LOs that are listed on the second page for each, on the second page for each learning unit, that LO stands for, I must take my caps lock off. The LO stands for learning objective. I know those of you who have already done modules last year will know this, but in case there are those of you that don't know this. And these learning objectives are the outcomes on which you will be tested. In other words, they are telling you in this module outline, in this list of objectives, exactly what they will ask you in the assessments. They are telling you, I will ask you to please record financial transactions in a debtor's ledger and a creditor's ledger. So that is a skill you must practice because you will be required to know how to do that and you will be tested on it. You will also please prepare a debtor's control account or a creditor's control account. So please practice doing exactly that because that's what they're going to ask you to do. So this will either come up in an assignment or it will come up in the exam or both, but you will have to do this. So remember, this is what you've got to practice. Make sure that these four objectives, you can do that. And for the exam purposes, you have to be able to do these tasks without a textbook in front of you and without any solutions in front of you. Just the question and your template in your answer book. So that is how you must practice because that's how you will have to do it in the exam. The assignments should be relatively easy because you've got the textbook in front of you with solutions and examples, and you've got time to complete that. The exam is only 3 hours, no textbook, no solutions. It's just you and what you've practiced and what you've memorized. Okay, so let me just check. So that's the outline and the pace and the learning objectives we've covered. So then I want to just quickly make sure that you guys know about your pairs. Okay, so this is, I'm sure you've heard people refer to the pairs. And that stands for Program Assessment Schedule. So the important thing with this is at the top over here, always make sure that you have got the latest version. The onus is on the students to make sure to keep checking whether another PAS has been updated and that you are consulting the latest one, because if you don't, you might get these dates incorrect. So here we have 5122. So here's our where's my pen gone? Here's our module here, 5122. And assignment one due on the 18th of April, assignment two due on the 3rd of May. They haven't yet given us exam dates, so we will get another version as soon as they finalize the dates and they've published another version of the PAS with the exam dates on it as well. Okay, take note, the assignments must be uploaded before 9 o'clock. At 9 o'clock, the system shuts down and does not accept any more uploads. So allow time for load shedding, technical issues, slow Wi-Fi, and all the rest of it. You've got to have your assignment ready for upload at least a couple of hours before that, that 9 o'clock deadline. Okay. So that's what I wanted to cover with the PAS. The ICE I've already spoken to you about. The assignment, we've discussed that. And again, we'll have our NSS closer to the time. The textbook, we've gone over that. Your assignment document. So please, guys, make sure that you have downloaded the assignment documents. Assignment one and two should already be available for download. And make sure that you can open them. There have been some issues with some of the modules where the students haven't been able to open the documents because they had a security lock on them. So immediately, as soon as possible, download it, make sure you can open it, start reading through the questions so that as you start working through the learning units, you are familiar with the questions in the assignment and you already know what you're looking for in the textbook so that you can start looking at where am I going to find my answers for my assignment. Then what we are going to do with all of these recordings and narrated slides and any other information or material that we've got to upload for the students, we will be creating a YouTube channel. So I will have a YouTube channel. Each tutor will have their own YouTube channel, and there will be a playlist for each module. So once that's created and on the go, I will send you via announcements the link for the YouTube channel, and you'll be able to find everything there. So even these recordings of the collabs will be uploaded to the YouTube channel. They won't be available on Learn or on Blackboard because we've been told that all of the recordings just take up too much data space on the system, and it slows the system down. So we have to, once this is, the recordings are completed, I will download the recording and then upload it to the YouTube channel where it will be permanently available for you. So that will be set up. And then also a WhatsApp group for the module. I will create a WhatsApp group and send the link on announcement so that you guys can also join the WhatsApp group and chat to each other. Your module has only got, I think, 6 or 7 students on it, so there's not many of you. So it will be nice to have each other just to chat to as you go along. I won't be on the WhatsApp group. It will just be the students. And then the last thing that I wanted to show you is how to contact me if you've got, if you want to message me or email me. Please don't use, if I send you an announcement, don't reply to an announcement in order to, in other words, if I've sent you an announcement about a reminder for your ask, don't reply to that announcement with a content question about a particular learning unit, because those messages are going to get lost, particularly if several students all reply with completely different topics to the same announcement thing. They get completely lost. So I'm just going to go here to share my screen with you. And show you exactly how to do that. Okay, so on the screen now, you should hopefully be able to see kind of like something that looks like a kaleidoscope. So if I go, let me just go to your course 5122. So your screen should look similar to this. This is what it looks like from my side, but student screen should look similar. So on your menu down here on the left-hand side, when you log into your module, you are looking for this menu item called Contact the Tutor. If you click on that, you then go here and you say send a message to the tutor. And then you get this screen, which is course messages. So this screen will show inbox and sent. So any messages that I have replied to your message will be here as well. You go up to the top here where it says create message. Okay, and then it opens what looks like a little email field. You click on to. My name should be right at the top. So you click on Heather and you press that little arrow, which will pop it into the recipient's box. And then you go down here, type in the subject. And then over here, hi, ma'am. And whatever it is you want to tell me. And you type it in there. And then at the bottom here, you press submit. And it will send this message to me and I will get a notification that there is a message waiting for me and I'll be able to read it and reply to it, etc. Okay, so this is the correct way to send messages to me if you've got any questions at all. It's honestly, it's the best way to do it. So please use that system. There are things about it that I don't like, but in terms of being able to track and trace messages and responses, it does work better than replying to random announcements. Okay. Guys, that is the list of everything that I specifically wanted to cover this evening with you. So also, in order not to keep these recordings and that too long for students to go through, I'm going to wrap it up here for this evening. And then I will see you guys again. The next collab with you guys, let me have a look here in the dark, 5122, will be on Monday, the 20th of March. Did I already say that? I can't remember. So Monday, the 20th of March. And because you guys were at 6:30 this evening, the next time, your one will be at 5:30. So everybody gets a turn to be earlier and later. But I will obviously be chatting to you in the announcements plenty of times before that and keeping in touch. And then I hope to hear from you guys as well with any questions whatsoever that you've got for me. Okay, guys, thank you very much. I hope you have all enjoyed this and found it useful. From my side, it's critical that you take note of what's been covered in this evening session. It's really important, and I hope it's been helpful. All right, guys, looking so forward to working with you this semester, and I hope everything goes super well for you. I'm going to stop the recording now and then chat to you again soon. Bye, guys.